Luigi Fenu, Eleonora Congiu, Giuseppe Carlo Marano, and Bruno Brisighella, Carve Shell supported footbridges. Okay, Luigi is the presenter. Is it right? Luigi, is possible you have the microphone turned off?
I think now it works.
Okay, very well. Thank you so much.
Bye. Sorry. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. This presentation is a summary of our research in shell-supported bridges in the last 15 years, maybe. And we initially followed Musmeci work, and he shaped his shell bridges using many methods, for instance, soap bubbles, differential equations, rubber physical models, and always starting from shaping shells with isotropic curvatures, and then by changing the transverse curvature. And initially we shaped some footbridges following Musmeci's method. And then we also applied topology optimization coupled with the form finding procedure. And then we turned to curved shell supported footbridges that were mainly shaped using a particle spring system. There is a problem with the video. Okay, because I didn't see the video. Your faces were hiding the video. Besides the particle spring system, we also used a non-standard thrust network analysis and compared the results. And finally, now we are studying the seismic for finding of curved shell-supported footbridges, mainly using a particle spring system. And here we see our initial work following Musmeci's work, with Musmeci's method of shaping an isotropic surface and then reducing the transverse curvature. And some years later, the year later, we tried to follow his method and to shape a footbridge, and we also studied how to build it by using ferrocement for instance, initially a tension structure made of steel wires, and then obtaining ferrocement and so on, and then by spraying the concrete to finally obtain the shell. This work is of 2005. And this is the footbridge. And then we applied topology optimization and together the fault finding method. And this method was also applied to a real bridge, the Sandona Bridge in close to Venice. And then we studied covered shell supported footbridges. Here we see how to apply the boundary conditions. And here we use the particle spring system. And using an auxiliary tension structure that you can see here. Here we see a photo montage, a perspective view of the foot of the shell supported footbridge, and also detailing of the deck that is a cantilever deck, and then we needed to apply pre-stressing and to exploit the ring shape of the girder. And we also used the TNA, the thrust network analysis, but we had to use it in a non-standard way, because the standard block way of performing TNA, we cannot apply to a surface whose projection is superimposed, while in the horizontal direction the shell of the bridge has not superimposition between the different part of the shell. So we applied the TNA in the horizontal direction, and then we checked by finite elements with the actual vertical loads, and then again in a loop until we find good results. And here we see what are we doing now. For instance, a shell supported footbridge with curve and the counter curve of the deck in some way following Schleich's work. And here we see the fault finding under both vertical and the seismic loads. In particular, we are investigating how the seismic loads affect the shape of the shell supporting the deck. Of course, it is necessary to, it is a, we the deck is not imposed as in the previous example, but the shape of the deck is affected by the seismic loads. And so we see how increasing the seismic loads affect the shape of the shell and of the deck. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Luigi, for your presentation. We have a question from Francesco. Please, Francesco.
Thank you for your presentation, Luigi. So, I find beautiful the choice of having a deck that is actually a cantilever, but it is acting in torsion on the membrane. Did you account for that torsion
Of course, because
the form finding.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know, the form finding not, not because actually, it the deck was injured. So the cantilever is injured to the shell.
And so, who cares about the torsion?
Which and, part? Torsion, we pre-stress the girder, and since we pre-stress a ring girder, then we can counteract the torsion.
Okay.
Exploiting the properties of ring girders.
And another thing, the seismic action, of course, is acting in both directions.
Yeah,
both positive and negative. Did you account for both, of course?
Of course.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.